be safe about this. Always put the brake on. It's very important. Oh. Okay. Whew. It's warm in here. And it's raining outside. Well, hello, everyone. Oh, that was so nice. Thank you. Oh. I was just pushing my friend up here on stage. I'm told he's a lucky stiff. In fact, he's been a lucky stiff on stage since 2006, for anyone who was here for that performance. Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Well, I can't remember his name, and he won't tell me. In fact, he doesn't really move. So someone just told me to bring him up on stage and just leave him be, and do not remove his sunglasses. He must have an eye disorder or something. I don't know. Anywho, my name is Sister Mary Paul. You might remember me as Sister Amnesia back in 2010, but I still remember my name. Okay. You should remember the performance that the sisters and I performed back then, and Sister Hubert asked me to do the quiz. So I thought it would be a good time to do another quiz. Just out of curiosity, who saw that performance of Nunsense? Anyone? Yes! Oh, good. Thank you. Glad to have you here. Okay. You know, I always know what time it is back at the convent because we have this huge clock with the 12 apostles pasted on it. And I always know when the big hand is on the Paul and the little hand is on the Peter, it's time for the sisters to go down on their knees. And pray. Okay, well now it's time for that quiz that I warned you about. Okay, here are the questions that you should have the answer to if you've been to Silver Bay, which you all have. Yay. Now, if you know the answer, you raise your hand. Are you ready? Are you ready? Oh, good. Okay. Question number one. My favorite place in the world is right here on Lake George. It has great French toast, fun children's leaders, and tennis. My favorite place in the world is Silver
Bay.
Yes! But nobody raised their hand. Okay. Let's try that again. Same question. My favorite place in the world is Silver
Bay.
I'm going to pick this gentleman right here. Yes. What's the answer? Yes. Bay. That's good. Would you have known the answer if everyone hadn't blurted it out? Oh, good. You're honest. Here I come. I have a prize. After I switch my card over. Oh, no, I almost dropped him. It's a holy prize. It's beautiful. Wait till you see it. I got it in my fanny pack. Let's see. Where is it? It's coming. It's coming. Look at that. It's a St. Christopher Motorist Prayer Book. Isn't that beautiful? Here. And right here. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yes. Oh, stand up. Take a bow. Take a bow. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yes. Go ahead. Thank you. Thank you. So, if you open it up, it says, I am a Catholic In case of accident, please call a priest. Why are you smiling? Yeah, you put your name on there and your address, and then when you can drive, you can put that in your car. Okay, well, you just do whatever you want with it. St. Christopher's in your pocket. Are you Catholic? No? Oh. Oh. What are you? Presbyterian. Oh. Well, you know the part where it says, I am a Catholic, please call, you know, call a priest, you can just kind of scratch that out. That, yes, you can put Presbyterian. Okay, all right, okay. I'm so glad you like that. Okay, here I come again. Oh. Okay. I gotta ask you though, if you have an accident, who do you call? An ambulance. That's probably pretty smart. Okay. All right, question number two. Are you ready?
Yes.
Oh, good. What was the Emp musical in 1968? Does anybody know that answer? Oh, is that Bill Baker? Guys and Dolls, yes! Good job! He would know the answer to that. Okay, next question. What was the Emp musical in 1974? Guys and Dolls, yes! What was the Emp musical in 1984? Yes, you guys are so smart! Okay, what was the Emp musical in 1997? Guys and Dolls! Very good! Very good! It's such a great show. We just have to keep repeating it. Okay, this next one will be really easy. What was the Emp musical in 1995? Not Guys and Dolls. I need to see really high hands. High, okay. Go ahead, what do you think? Not Guys and Dolls. What? Not Guys and Dolls. Nope, nope. I'll give you a hint. There's lots of nuns in it. Sound of Mute, well, wait. Nobody raised their hand. Except you, I saw you back there. What, did you know it was Sound of Music?
No, I thought that was Nunsense.
Oh, well that was a good show too. Who said Sound of Music? Somebody raise their hand, because you're gonna get prize. I'm going past the first row here. Past the first row. Someone over 20. Here I come. Oh, I got something good for you. I bet you can't wait to see what I have. Okay. Let's see. What's next? Oh, she gets a beautiful doll. No. Just wait. It's a beautiful doll of a saint. I made it myself. Isn't that beautiful? I made it at the Silver Bay Craft Shop just yesterday. Yeah, they're really great up there. It's made of cotton and nylon and the fluffy stuff that you put inside and some googly eyes. Here you go. Do you know what saint that is? No? No? Are you Catholic? No? Do we have any? Netflix here tonight? Oh, hey, give that back to me. I'll give it. Do you know who that is? Wait, no, it's you. Do you know who that is? Oh, just take a guess. The flying nun. Who's that? Oh, that's the flying nun? Okay, yeah! Thank you! Thank you! Here I come again! Here comes the flying nun! You get to keep this! I made it for you! Yes! There you go! And if you feel her head, her eyes Google. Okay. Get back on stage. Two more questions. The auditorium was built in 1907 and then burned down 1 year later. Isn't that sad? But there is a beautiful part of the story. The bell was recovered, and through donations, the auditorium was built 1 year. 1 year later. And there's an inscription on the bell. It says, "To the glory of God." Isn't that beautiful? To the glory of God and in loving memory of Mrs. Mary S. Ackerman Hoyt. Oh, I didn't ask the question. What happened to the auditorium a year after it was built? Hands. Hands. Yes. Good, but I'm pointing to the girl next, behind you. Yes, that's you. Yes. Oh, good! Here I come again! Okay, let's see what I have here for you. This is a sticker. It's supposed to be a sticker of St. Francis. He's the patron saint of animals. But we ran out of them. We don't have any more. We just ran out, like a gazelle. So you get to have You get a Luigi. Oh, let me tell you something. I always thought St. Francis was a sissy. No, that's very wrong. Reverend Mother corrected me. No, it's St. Francis of Assisi. Yeah, that's very different. Oh, are there any other Catholics here tonight? Oh my gosh, you're all up there. You're closer to God. Is there anyone on the bottom floor? Right there. Hello. I have a prize for you just for being Catholic. I bet you never thought it would pay off. This, here we go. This is a prayer card to Saint Dimphna. She is the patron saint of people with mental disorders. It's from my own personal collection, and I brought it for you. Reverend Mother told me I should pray to her every night. Okay, all right. The last question is gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Do you all want the 2022 Silver Bay Broadway Revue to begin? Yes! Oh, good! Okay. Let's do it.
You ready to start the show? Let's go, people! Yeah! Male costumes to the left! Are the props on the table? Hey, You look good. Are the new lights up yet? We haven't had a show on this stage for 2 years. We need sparkle. We need shine. We need to have fun. We are gonna have fun. Yay! Another opinion, another show. In Philly, Boston, in Baltimore.
A chance for stage folks to say hello. Another run, another show.
Another job that you hope at last
will make the future forget your past.
Another pin where the ulcers grow.
Another opening of another show.
4 weeks you rehearse and rehearse. 3 weeks and it couldn't be worse.
1 week will it ever be right?
Then out of the hat, it's that opening night.
The overture is about to start. You cross your fingers and hold your heart. It's over and away we go. Another opening of another show.
Another opening of another show.
To get Professor Harold Hill's credentials. However, they're struggling to find their corporate synergy. Luckily, finding synergy and distraction is Professor Hill's greatest talent.
So here is my love song. Not fancy or fine. Lida Rosa, won't you be mine, be mine? Lida Rosa, I'm home again, Rose, to get the sun back in the sky. Lida Rosa, I'm home again, Rose, about a thousand kisses shy. Ding dong ding. I can hear the chapel bells chime. Ding, dong, ding. At the least suggestion about the question, Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Lida Rose, now everyone knows that I'm hoping you're the same. So here is my love song. You're fine. Lida Rose, oh, won't you be my Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose.
Beetlejuice is invisible to all living things unless he is able to get a living person to say his name 3 times. Lydia, a young girl who has just lost her mother, is depressed. Beetlejuice is surprised that Lydia can see him and wants her to free him. Barbara and Adam, a newly deceased couple, want to help Lydia and warn her about the dangers of beetle, well, demon in question. Like, you got it, right?
September 11th, 2001. 38 planes have been diverted to the small town of Gander. That's over 6,000 passengers stranded in an airport that typically only receives a few planes a day. One of those 38 planes pilots finds herself thinking about how she got where she is.
My parents must have thought they had a crazy kid, 'cause I was one of those kids who always knew what I wanted. They took me down to the airport to see all the planes departing, watching them fly. Something inside of me was starting. I was 8 when I told them I'd be a pilot. But I was too young and too short, and there were no female captains. And my dad said, be patient, just see what happens. So I took my first lesson, came down from the sky, told my father I'd fly for the rest of my life. And I got my first job flying for a mortician in a tiny bonanza, just a corpse and me. $5 an hour for flying dead bodies. I had to climb over their faces just to get to my seat. And suddenly the wheels lift off. The ground is falling backwards. I am suddenly alive. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly something has changed. Suddenly I'm not too young or too short, and the passengers in the back don't complain. Suddenly I'm flying company charters. Suddenly everything's high. Suddenly there's nothing in between me and the sky. American Airlines had the prettiest planes, so I applied as a flight engineer. But the World War II pilots, they all complained. They said girls shouldn't be in the cockpit. Hey lady, hey baby, hey, why don't you grab us a drink? And the flight attendants weren't my friends back then, and they said, are you better than us, do you think? But I kept getting hired, and the World War II crew, they retired, and the girls all thought much higher of me. 1986, the first female American captain in history. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly I've got my wings. Suddenly all of those pilots protesting me, well, they can get their own drinks. Suddenly there's no one saying stay grounded, looking down, passing them by. Suddenly there's nothing in between me and the sky. Suddenly I've got an all-female crew. The news talked, it made headlines across the world. Suddenly it stopped, no one saying you can't or you won't, or you know you're not anything 'cause you're a girl. Suddenly I'm getting married, and we're putting pins in the map where we've flown. Suddenly I am a mother, and suddenly shocked at how much they've grown. Suddenly I'm wondering how my parents would feel seeing me teaching men to be pilots. 'Cause suddenly I am a senior instructor, and somehow I'm 51. Suddenly I'm flying Paris to Dallas, across the Atlantic and feeling calm. When suddenly someone on air-to-air traffic says at 8:46 there's been a terrorist action, and the one thing I loved more than anything was used as the bomb. Suddenly I'm in a hotel. Suddenly something has died. Suddenly there's nothing in between me and the sky.
Donna is surprised and upset to see that her 3 ex-lovers at her daughter's wedding, spoiler, one of them is her daughter's father. Her friends try to cheer her up and convince her that she can still be the girl that she once was. When they invite her on stage, feel free to join and dance with them.
Get up on stage and join us for some free dancing from the audience. Come on up. Come on up, guys. Come on up. Yeah. You're a tease, you turn them on. Leave them burning and then you're gone. Looking out for another, anyone will do. You're in the mood for a dance. And when you get the chance, you are the dancing queen, young and sweet, only 17. Dancing queen, feel the beat from the tambourine, oh yeah. You can dance, you can jump. Digging the dancing queen. Digging the dancing queen. Digging the dancing queen. Janessa. Great job, guys, great job.
Give it up for Donna and her friends. Archibald is a father who enjoys reading to his sick, bedridden son. While he sleeps, he tells tales of dragons and maids and wizards.
Left off last night, the hideous dragon had carried the maid to his cave by moonlight. He gnashed his teeth, he breathed his fire, the earth quaked, and we trembled in fear. I said, someone must save this sweet raven-haired maiden, though surely the cost will be steep. So we lads all drew lots, our insides tied in knots, and I won. And the rest went to sleep. So I picked up my staff and I followed the trail of his smoke to the mouth of the cave. And I bid him come out. Yea, forsooth, I did shout. Ye fool dragon, be gone, or behave. And then under my breath, I uttered a charm. Said to make the worst fiends become kind. Knaves and knights of dire plights now diminish his sights. And it worked, and the dragon went blind. And he charged off the cliff, howling mad, and he died. And the maiden accepted my ring. And a son came along and was brave, bold, and strong. And his thanks every night now I sing. Race you to the top of the morning. Come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you. Climb hills to remind you. I love you, my boy, at my side. Now another foul dragon's appeared. I must leave you. He's scorching our land with his breath. From his lair, this one haunts me, he dares me, he taunts me. Once again, we must fight to the death. Would to God I could stay and instead slay your dragon, this beast who sits hunched on your back. How I wish I could wrench him away from your bed, or cut off, or tear off his terrible head, or breathe out my fire on him till he was dead. Or beg him to spare you and take me instead. As it is, I must leave you in care of my brother, the wizard who lives on. As promised, his art will soon pierce through the heart of this dragon that's keeping you ill. And I know that your mother, God bless her, would want you to do as he says and grow strong. And you know that as soon as I can, I'll return. So be brave, son, and know that I long to race you to the top of the morning. Come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you. Climb hills to remind you. I love you. I love you. My boy.
Thank you.
welcome to the weekly prayer meeting at the 42nd Street Mission. We will now hear the testimony from Brother Nicely Johnson. From Brother Nicely Johnson.
I dreamed last night I got on a boat to heaven, and by some chance I had brought my dice along, and there I stood, and I shouted, "Someone feed me!" But the passengers, they know right from wrong. And the people all said, sit down, you rock the boat. People all said, sit down, you rock the boat. For the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel of your chicken coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you rock the boat. And by some chance, found a bottle in my fist. And there I stood, nicely passing out the whiskey. But the passengers were bound to resist. And the people all said, beware, beware the scuttle the ship. They all said, those passengers to heaven, a great big wave came and washed me overboard. And as I sank and I hollered, "Someone save me!" That's the moment I woke up, thank the Lord.
You
say, the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. So remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. Quiet! You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I serve you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a Fulian battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say our love is draining and you can't go on. You'll be the one complaining when I am gone. And no, don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject. My sweet, submissive subject. My loyal, royal subject. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win for your love, for your praise. And I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing, 'cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Da 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 da.
Depressed King George. In the 17th century, we meet Don Quixote. He believes himself a knight on a glorious quest. The code of chivalry will be followed: truth, justice, and faith, even when the odds are impossible.
Impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar. To try when your arms are too weary to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this. That one man, scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable
star. The last time the Von Klieb family singers will be singing together for a long, long time. Captain Von Klieb has been commissioned by the Lake George Steamship Company to accept his new command as the captain of the Mohican. And as we speak, the authorities are waiting in the wings to escort him away to Lake George Village. With that being said, we will ask them to do an encore performance to say goodbye.
Oh, I see. So long farewell, as we wish in goodbye.
I fleet, I float, I flee, flee, I fly.
When people's voices are silenced, we need to stand together. We overcome adversity by becoming community and a family. Support those who have been wronged and love them. Listen with your heart. Listen to the music of the people.
Of the people who will not be slaves again. When the people
comment was then followed by a time limit, like it was one coming in 10 minutes, something like that. But it fast forward to this summer, I was asked to be on the stage by a wonderful person who has put this together, Jocelyn Fischer. She's done a magnificent job, and we want to thank her with some tokens of our applause.
But of course, I couldn't have done it without all of these guys. And thank you for opening up the auditorium once again. It's been 2 years since we've had a production on this stage. We couldn't do a musical this year, but I think this was better. So thank you. Thank you for coming.